Good morning, beautiful souls. It is Friday, November 5th. Wow, that is just so crazy. So how has this new moon in Scorpio energy been treating you? I would love to hear in the comments because this is supposed to be an extra super powerful new moon where you can bring your creative ambitions to life, where at the same time, secrets and wounds might be coming to the surface without even trying. I have a Scorpio moon, so I really thought that this was gonna be super intense new moon for me, but personally, I am feeling just like this wonderful creative energy where instead of thinking about problems or traumas, I am actually on the mindset of how to make better use of my time, how to solve problems. So I'm using this new moon as a problem solver. I actually just did my new moon spell jar. This is the second month I've done it. Last month, it was incredible, that new moon in Libra. And I'm not sure if I was just at a certain point on my journey where my intentions really took off, if it was the spell jar itself. Definitely check out my Etsy shop to get yourself one, because not only are they fun to make, but you really feel this powerful connection to your intentions, to what you want to manifest in your reality. So I did that and I really enjoyed that. But I have this really, I feel cleansed. I feel just whole. I have like this wholeness feeling to me. So I lucked out, because having a Scorpio moon with the new moon in Scorpio, shit could have really hit the fan for me. But I feel like through the last few months, it already has. So it was like building me up to this point. Like, this is my new moon, you know? So like, I'm excited. I set some powerful intentions. What did you set to intend to bring into your life this cycle? Also, I feel like I'm losing some of you on Facebook, since I'm just leaving the link to my YouTube channel instead of posting the actual video. I'm really sorry for that. It's so hard for me to post videos on four different social media platforms, but let me know, does it really make that big of a difference to you? Is it easier or something if I find a way to just post the video? It wasn't coming up. It's really weird. It was coming up so I could post it on Instagram, but then when I went to go post it on Facebook, like, it was like the video wasn't even on my phone. I couldn't find it. So it was really weird. It was almost like I was meant to share my YouTube channel. It was like a message. So, okay, let's get into today's message. We have compassion. This crestfallen elemental has given up the fight and does not know where to turn. Her naked form is cold and world-weary, and she no longer has the strength to deny her vulnerability or hide away from prying eyes. The dewy moss of the woodland floor provides a soft cushion to rest while she gathers her thoughts and prays for warmth and direction. I was not expecting this from this card. As the misty dawn breaks, a new pathway is gradually flooded with golden light, offering a clear route out of the glade. The spirit of compassion hovers above. As an empath, she feels the weight carried by the weary stranger, and her gaze remains soft, non-judgmental, and patient. It is only when the elemental looks heavenward for answers that the spirit of compassion can reveal herself and point the way. The presence of this card indicates that now is a favorable time to view the world through the healing properties of compassion. Be especially aware of any strong judgments and expectations carried by you or others, which may be freezing your ability to connect with an open heart. Practice extending sincere, unconditional love and caring to those around you, and face any problems you encounter with a sincere wish to alleviate suffering. Look heavenward for guidance and open your heart to the warm rays of compassion. Wow, guys, throughout the course of this week, we have been through centering, sanctuary, peace, and now compassion. And Spirit is showing me that if you did indeed take that time to create or find or go to your sanctuary and go within and find that balance and center within yourself. Remember, there was an issue. There was a situation that we had to take a step back from and really retreat so we could collect all the information and make an informed choice. And Spirit is showing me that for those of you who did that, that you do have this new sense of not only the peace that we had yesterday, but now we have compassion for yourself and for everybody, okay? Remember, I literally made the thing, you know, the comment about not judging people, like seeing someone driving with a mask on or just judging anybody, period. Like there's just no need for it. We really need to have peace and compassion in our hearts. And this actually has been leading up throughout the week. So I feel like part of this new moon in Scorpio energy is to show unconditional love towards yourself and towards everybody. Okay, there's no need for us to put ourselves in some drama, to create drama, to look at people like we know what they're going through, because we don't, right? So it's really time to show compassion for others as well as for ourselves. When you are in your sanctuary place seeking peace, okay, I want you to be compassionate towards yourself. When you start having negative self-talk and negative thoughts, I want you to show compassion for yourself, okay? And what I have learned to do is that whenever I find myself being really hard on myself, I think about how would I approach the situation if it were one of my kids or if it was somebody that I dearly love. You know, would I be talking to them in the same way that I'm talking to myself? Probably not. And then that helps me to show compassion for myself, because I know that, you know, if you love yourself like we should, then there should be no reason why, not just being hard on yourself, but why we should say nasty things to ourselves, you know? So today is really about compassion. I love that. And then for our starry beginnings, I awaken to the power within me. Oh my goodness, guys. So you guys have literally awoken the power within you by retreating to your sanctuary. Okay, and that's why Spirit was asking you to do that. Because by finding this centering and this balance and by finding this peace and compassion, you are literally awakening the love within you. And love is the most powerful magic of all, okay? So you are awakening to the power of love within you, and you're awakening to your own inner strength and your own self-awareness, okay? I'm seeing you awakening to being on the journey to connecting to a higher consciousness and to your higher self. This is amazing, okay? You are awakening to the power within you. Wow. Let me know in the comments. Do you feel like you are right now? Do you really feel like the trauma and the pain and the healing and the hurt and the dark that it has brought you to this point where you did have to retreat and now you are able to really feel woke? You know, it's like, I am awake now. And it's an incredibly powerful feeling when you get to that moment. It doesn't just happen once, it happens over and over again in our lives where we have that aha moment. But Spirit is really telling you that you have awoken to this enlightenment, to this spiritual advancement, to awakening to your journey, to your soul path, your life journey, what your soul asked to work on completing and the challenges that it asked to experience when you came down to earth during this specific incarnation. You are awakening to that power so you can follow your north node, so you can follow what your soul truly desires. Okay, continue to show that compassion to yourself and to others. practice always practice self-love. It is a never-ending journey, okay? And then with that peace within you, it's just really going to keep you on this track of being awoken, all right? And now you're in the light. You've awoken to the light. This is such a powerful message. I love it for being right after the new moon in Scorpio. This is the energy that you have received, that you are starting off this brand new chapter, this new slate, this next cycle with. You're starting it with peace and compassion in your heart. So that is wonderful news. I am super excited, guys. I say it all the time, super excited. Oh my gosh. All right, so that is it for today. I hope you all have a super awesome Friday. It is the weekend. Love, light, and blessings, and I'll be back tomorrow. Bye, guys.